It is, like I said earlier in the show, with all eyes turning to Atlantic City next week, there is still plenty of product to be had at your local shop next week. A total of 10 new trading card products releasing. This is Hot in the Shop, a look ahead at next week's new releases for the week of August 1st, 2016. Part one. We had to split it up this week, Ivan. That's how busy it is.
Wow.
I know you're doing stuff, so I'll jump right in here, and you
Oh,
just do
go
what you got
for
to
it.
do and jump in when you're ready. Kicking things off, we got back-to-back hockey products from Upper Deck, one of the last 2015-16 products of the calendar year or season year, I should say. NHL Black Hockey. Black Hockey delivers one lustrous rookie signature card, one base card, and four premium autograph or relic cards in every product. Upper Deck is promising that NHL Black will produce some of the season's most desirable hockey cards. They're promising. I mean, that's big words. The configuration breakdown: 8 boxes, 2 4-box inners, and 6 cards per box. So base cards hard to come by, just one per box. The lustrous rookie signature cards, great rookie class. These are going to be super hot, I guarantee it. And then 4 additional premium autograph or relic cards, featuring the top 50 NHL rookies, numbered to 299, 199, 25, and 101s are those lustrous rookie cards. Other things to be looking for: Black Tie Affair, which features the entire laced section from a game-used jersey. I absolutely love that. I've never had the fortune of pulling one. Maybe the streak that I'm on will be strong enough that we'll be able to pull one of those eventually when we get some Upper Deck hockey product back on the show. Big fan of that. Look for lustrous ink in autographs, dual jersey, and dual patches, all printed on acetate. New this year, Pro Penmanship, single, dual, triple, and quad autographs. Showcase relic set, which is loaded with patches, and find 6 variations of patches and autographed patch cards. Additional content includes Pride of a Nation, Cup Coronation, Black Ice, and more. Check out gogts.net for a complete product breakdown, as well as the checklist, which are both available. And Hot in the Shop will be posted on Monday, as always. So that is a look at
Wow.
2015-16 Black Hockey.
So that was 2015-16, and one of possibly the highest end products you could chase after. I mean, not ridiculously, but it's a high end
Very, yeah,
product. You
it's
gotta
not the
love that.
cup, but it's getting there.
Yeah, well, and if for whatever reason, if you can't afford that, or you don't want to try getting into a box break because you're worried that someone might hurt themselves trying to open the packs, Upper Deck is also releasing 2016-17 MVP hockey cards, which are a bit more accessible for the average collector. So you got two options coming from Upper Deck this week, both of them beautiful hockey sets. This one delivers 5 colors and contours inserts per box. A box has 20 packs and 8 cards. It also has a combination of 3 of NHL territories and leading lights inserts, has
Which
12
look
puzzle
really
backs,
cool.
and oh yeah. Yeah, check that out in the little video there, looking good. And 8 silver script parallels in every box. And then, of course, there could be a rookie redemption card. Well, there will be a rookie redemption card, 1 in every case. And those are redeemable for a total of 8 cards, plus, in every case, 2 autographs and 3 memorabilia cards. So, again, a little more accessible. But there is still a chase going on there. There is still some hits that you can get.
Absolutely. Later in the show, I'm going to tell you why Upper Deck MVP Hockey is one of the most undervalued products in the market right now for this year. And
Well, I can almost tell you that right now. Just take a look at these pictures. It's a nice accessible product, but look at that design. Like, this is a good Upper Deck product. Like, this reminds me of like 93 SP, or something like that. Like, this is something that would be fun to
Good
open.
eye.
Great photography, great design, a little bit of shininess, but not like over the top garishness. I like this product. Just it reminds me of like a high class collector's choice, actually, would maybe be a better way
to put
it.
I like that analogy. I mean, this is the first hockey product of the new season, which means training camp must be right around the corner. So perfect time to release at the National, August 3rd. You know, people will be taking advantage of the first cards of the new rookie crop. Very, very cool. All right, next up, we've got 2016 Donruss football. And not only is this going to be available in hobby, but you're also going to see team sets and special quarterback sets at retail. But as far as the hobby version goes, you're going to get one autograph, one memorabilia, six parallels, 24 rookies, and 43 inserts in every box. Find two different Peyton Manning tribute sets and the return of Fans of the Game. Woohoo! A very popular insert set from yesteryear. Well, not that yesteryear, maybe 2006, but it's back. And so a lot of diverse content in this product. It's one of those things that you're going to find something different in every pack you open, with one rookie per pack and one parallel or insert per pack. All your favorite stuff is in here. The rookies, Dominators, Elite Series rookies, Gridiron Kings, all-time Gridiron Kings. The list goes on and on. As we said, one autograph and one memorabilia card in every box. Look for rookie phenom card, jersey autographs of the 2016 NFL rookie class, including Ivan's boy Ezekiel Elliott, top one and two draft picks Jared Goff and Carson Wentz, passing the torch memorabilia cards, including prime versions numbered as low as 25. So this is an affordable product. It's a set builder's product, 400 base cards. And then killer subsets, classic, Gridiron Kings, Statline Parallels, and more. This is going to appeal to a diverse range of collectors, people that want to get in early on football, set builders. And you know there's going to be people buying this just for Fans of the Game, including Daisy Ridley, Megan Fox, Al Pacino, and more. Plus, 1987 Classics is a hobby exclusive insert. Look for that and more. Yeah. I love you. You know that. All right. 2016 Leaf in the Game used hockey cards. Yes, three hockey products releasing next week. But have no fear. If it's a sport, it has a product next week. Just happens to fall on the first half of Hot in the Shop here. We got three hockey products. In the Game used hockey, as we talked about with Greg Cohn a few weeks ago, is going to feature five premium memorabilia cards in every box, featuring a collection of some super rare vintage memorabilia. If you want an idea of what we're talking about, you can watch the video on GoGTS.net or our YouTube channel, or take a look at Leaf_cards on Twitter. They have been showing some boom, mind-blowing stuff. Stuff that I didn't even realize that there was relics of stuff this old from some of hockey's all-time greatest players. Boasting a robust checklist of true legends. I mean, I'll give you just a handful. Vezina, Plant, Warder, Sawchuk, Brimzik, Howe, Bellevue, Gretzky, Lemieux, Waugh, Esposito, Hall, Bossy, Richter, LaFontaine, Modano, Sittler, Clark. I mean, you know, if they're a legend, they're in here. So five premium memorabilia cards in every box, the key being game-used memorabilia. When Leaf and In the Game partnered together and kind of transitioned production over to Leaf, all of the assets acquired by In the Game in their history went to the vault coffers, if you will, of Leaf. And so they've just got tons of material. This is one of the most extensive sell sheets I've ever seen come from Leaf. So please check it out at GoGTS.net or Hot in the Shop next week and take a look at all the just dynamic content. And then Leaf's got something else. Ivan, can you do this one or you want me to?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, no, I was excited for this. Because this is the first ever certified autographs of tennis star Serena Williams produced by a major trading card manufacturer in a tennis card set. Is in 2016 Leaf metal tennis card. So Rob was not lying when he said every sport will be represented right. this week. Even box breaking is getting its own set at the National. 2016 Leaf metal tennis cards delivers 5 autographed cards in every box. So these are simple, loaded boxes. 12 boxes per case, which means that there is 60 autographed cards per case because all 5 of the cards in your box are going to be autographed. And this is metal tennis, so we see a lot of well-known metal designs, including, I don't know what they call it, but it's a one-of-one gold, lots of X's fractor.
Prismatic, I think, is the official thing, isn't it?
No, prismatic is the appropriate one. And it's funny and exciting to me that Serena Williams is almost like the only one to talk about when you're looking at a set that includes Roger Federer on multiple cards, multiple card designs, Andy Murray, Anna Kournikova, tons of great tennis stars, and one of the first like all tennis sets we've seen in a long, long time. In fact, I'm curious actually when even there was the last tennis set. Do you know, Ron?
Yes, Leaf did a non-metal tennis set. I want to say sometime in the last 12 months. But what was funny is Leaf got called out on their solicitation, and thank you for the way that you read or brought the description of the product. Serena, as you might remember, had trading cards and I believe autographed trading cards. And was it Allen and Ginter or was it Goodwin? Or yes, Allen and Ginter. So they had to add the caveat in a trading card set or in a tennis card set, excuse me. So it wasn't the fact that it was the first ever produced by a major trading card manufacturer. It was in a trading card or tennis card set. So it was funny. Yeah. They got called out on that. And I went back and had to add that to the solicitation and the blog post and all that. Just CYA, yeah. As you know.
Well, that's it.
Go ahead.
Well, I didn't realize we were going down. I don't know what CYA means.
You don't? Cover your ass?
No. Oh, okay. Yeah. Now I see why you said CYA instead of saying it. But thank you for humoring me. So I'm actually a little curious because I saw the tweet and the original tweet they sent out said that.
Right.
But are you saying that the solicitation sheet did not have that specification? Because I think that the person that called them out on it just didn't seem to realize that that's what they
yeah,
said.
Yeah, it seemed a little like there's just people are so quick to criticize and point out people's mistakes. It's just the culture we live in. I guarantee you, Brian Gray at Leaf fully knew that she had certified autograph trading cards in the market before. It was just, you know, a little, it hadn't been in a designated tennis card set. You have to remember, Leaf acquired mm-hmm. Ace Authentic, which, you know, a few years ago, which was the primary manufacturer of tennis trading card sets, but they had not been able to get Serena into a product. Leaf was. So obviously they were excited to be able to get her in a tennis card set. It's just a big whoop-de-doo about nothing. But too hot in the shop. You want to go first? You want me to go first?
I can go first because you know what we got coming up? More Leaf. Leaf holds everything for the National because they want to be up on the stage with us the whole time. Brian Gray and us ripping packs. I remember watching you do this break with them last year. 2016 Leaf Pop Century trading cards. This is one that's really fun to open live, too, right,
absolutely.
Rob? Like, it's just fun to open as a group and get people's feedback.
I recruited Brian to do another case on the stage this year, free. So,
yes,
stop on by. You go, and I'll tell you when the timing of that is.
Oh, I go where?
Keep going. And
you're trying to get me off the stage, and then...
Yeah, that's what I mean.
When you leave the stage is when me and Brian will open all these cool cards. So this product, though, 10 boxes per case. So you'll watch Rob and Brian open 10 boxes at the National on the Rip and Wax Rip and Wax main stage pavilion with Mike Berkus's name on top. This will deliver 4 hit cards per box. And these hit cards, what's a hit card when you're talking about pop century? Well, pop culture from the past century. I don't know if they actually cut it off at 1916 or not, but what that means is celebrity autographs. Celebrity autograph sketch cards. Jumbo celebrity memorabilia in every box. And something very cool
this
year.
Which is a mix.
Well, the first thing they tout.
That's new for this year. It's a good thing that you point that out. It used to be just straight autos, but they've mixed it up to include some different content.
So, in addition to the different content, allegedly the strongest autograph checklist ever. Now, we can say that, but I still don't know. That's like saying standout rookies when the season hasn't started. So, Brian, I am going to call you out on that and say, I don't know. Prove it at the National, on the stage. I'll be there. But what they can prove, and what I do think adds even more value to the product, lower production run. They cut the production run by 8%. And again, super rare autograph sketch cards. We don't have exact odds on those, but they're going to be really hard to find, as well as the jumbo celebrity memorabilia. And I mean, I shouldn't even be talking about that because the checklist, oh my gosh, number one on the checklist. You guys will all flip out. I know it. I don't care. There's one hater in the world I know who might not care, but everyone else, Daisy Ridley is in this product.
Yes, she is.
Daisy Ridley.
The free case break of this product is Friday at noon. So if you're going to be at the National and want to see this product and have an opportunity to get in on the break, be sure to stop by the Case Break Pavilion in the main stage.
It's going to be awesome. So Daisy Ridley, Kevin Costner, Idina Menzel, Megan Fox, Chevy Chase, Boy George, Al Pacino, some notorious non-signers are in this product, and some notorious awesome people, Norman Reedus.
Yep. Megan Fox.
Norman Reedus.
Nev Campbell. Shannon Doherty.
One more time.
Tim Curry.
Tim Curry. The star of the critically acclaimed hit film Congo. Tim Curry. Mr. James Bond himself, Roger Moore. God, this is like my dream product right here. Along with Bill Shatner and Kristen Bell, who's one of the sweetest, nicest people I ever know. Along with her husband, Dax Shepard. I don't see his name.
Mina Savari is in here. Remember her from American Beauty?
Yeah. Kiefer Sutherland, who's another rare autograph signer in public. And he's on one of the super rare autograph sketch cards. Marcus Mumford, Adam West. That's always a fun one. And then some of that celebrity memorabilia that we were talking about. Whitney Houston.
Yeah.
Elvis Presley.
My guy, Frank. That's all you need to say.
Old Blue Eyes. But listen to this. I'm actually getting goosebumps about this. James Cagney.
Yep. Cher.
So, wow. I could literally just read this checklist.
I know. It's kind of that just A-list. Boom, 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 boom. How about the super rare autograph sketch cards? Hugh Jackman. 50 Cent, Sharon Stone, Kate Beckinsale, Kiefer Sutherland. Awesome.
Excellent.
I don't know if Frank Stallone is in here.
Didn't you pull a Frank Stallone last year?
I think Scotty Frank Schwartz Stallone is in here. I think maybe he is. Who knows?
Frank Stallone used to be a regular at the restaurant that I worked at before I worked at the nice restaurant. He would come into the less nice restaurant. He was a funny guy.
That's funny.
Nice guy. Anyways, the show is going off the rails real quick if we just read celebrities' names.
Listen to Rob and Ivan drool over reading celebrity names. But yeah, so check that out.
Hugh Jackman. Oh, but actually, real quick, sure. Though, look at those sketch cards. I wasn't actually, because I was reading names, I wasn't actually looking at the cards. Wow. Have you been showing those the whole time in the show? The sketch cards look awesome. The base cards, which are all super limited, look awesome. These are cool looking cards, too. It's not just a checklist. Oh, man. These cards are not going to be given away at the National. These cards are going in my pocket.
Guess what else is releasing next week?
Oh, I can't even. My mind is so blown right now. You could tell
go
me.
Go ahead.
That
you
Noah's Ark
you,
is releasing
you drool
next week
over that page. Because I know some people are going to be very excited because NASCAR is back in trading cards next week, Wednesday the 3rd, Panini Prism Racing, delivering one autographed, two memorabilia cards, plus nine inserts, 10 prisms, including a one green prism numbered to 149 or less, two additional prisms numbered to 99 or less, and then look for a case hit. Every case is going to deliver one autographed card of either Kevin Harvick, Jimmy Johnson, Danica Patrick, or Dale Earnhardt Jr. Those are some big names, and the fact that they've included case hits with those people is pretty awesome. Look for patented penmanship, nine versions featuring eight parallels numbered to 99 or less, driver signatures, nine different parallels, including the hard-to-find black numbered to 3. As far as race-used memorabilia, look for tire and fire suit fabric cards. Inserts include winner's circle, competitors, and more. And then SP variations. Find rare variations of the base set featuring retired legends like Dale Earnhardt and Daryl Waltrip, so like old school. The checklist is out for that, so if you want to know what's up in Panini Prism Racing, go to gogts.net and you'll be able to find all that info.
Tons of info on Panini Racing, and finally tons of product hitting at the National.
Yeah, it's awesome.
How many of you are going to be excited to see that? Let us know in the chat room what your thoughts are. And if you're going to want us to maybe broadcast some of that, I'm sure we could get Tracy to open at least a box on the main stage too. That would be fun to show
Absolutely.
People. But hey, Rob, you mentioned
what did I mention?
That there's more sports still to be represented.
More
right?
sports.
So how about, well, what's going on right now? We got baseball
we
going
do
on?
We have baseball going on. Tell them about it.
How about Topps? Are they going to put some stuff on this list? Are they going to put something shiny on this list? Like Topps Chrome Baseball 2016?
Boom!
Boom. Owe me a Coke. Topps Chrome Baseball delivers two autographed cards in every box, including Carlos Correa's 2015 Topps Chrome autographed rookie cards.
Why 2015?
And how cool
you
is
ask?
That?
Because they couldn't get them in the product in time, so instead of destroying them, which sometimes they do, they're putting them in this product.
Well, and let me say, because that was a big controversy once when it happened without it being talked about, at least they're telling us. Got to give them props for that. We asked them to tell us these things.
Transparency.
And they told us, look, in advance, going to have some Carlos Correa 2015 Topps Chrome autograph cards in there. So in addition, though, to those always highly coveted autograph rookie cards, this will offer tons of new insert content, including a Chrome first pitch set.
Oh,
that series continuing. Low-numbered veteran autographs, a complete rainbow of colored refractors. Well, that's not actually that new, unless it actually is Roy G. Biv.
Rainbow.
But also look for hobby-only hot boxes, where all base cards are replaced by
black
refractors.
That's cool. Can you imagine?
That's been the PC thing lately. So did I mention two autograph cards? And I cannot imagine an entire box replaced by a limited edition.
You
refractor.
Just start opening a pack and you're like, wait a minute.
Yeah. How, like, would you, here's a question. Here's a poll or something. I don't know. Guys, just tell me. Even though I'm on a roll and I'm not reading the chat room, cause I'm reading this awesome checklist sell sheet spec sheet. If you open one pack and you see that, do you put the other 23 packs on either?
That is a good question.
I'm not kidding.
No, I'm laughing.
I'm not kidding.
I
like,
totally
think about
agree
it.
With you, and it yeah. would give me pause, that's for sure.
So case hit, and this is called a Roy Chronicles insert. I don't know. Is that Roy from that baseball movie?
Or is it?
They've been doing that as a continuation.
Or is it
Wah? Yeah. Yeah, maybe it's Wah. Maybe it's a hockey tribute. It's all caps, though, so maybe return on yours. One Rookie of the Year Chronicles insert is the baseball card's case hit. And we've got tons of new autographed sets, youth impact autographs, team logo autographs, Roy Chronicles autographs, as we mentioned, parallels for all of those sets, as well as non-autoed versions of Youth Impact, First Pitch, and Roy Chronicles, which is active veterans who have won Rookie of the Year. And Carlos Correa everywhere. AL Roy, Carlos Correa.
It's a good thing he's still good, right?
Topps Chrome rookie autograph cards. Yeah, it is. Though you've seen things like Schwarber on Donruss Optic, like on the box, but it happens, you know. And you always got to take a bit of a risk, if you will. Like Josh Bell, I noticed that he got his first Topps Now card, and I'm like, that's mainly just to celebrate the fact that he finally made it to the majors and had an at-bat. Thankfully, it was a home run as well. Image variations also hidden in this product, and if you aren't looking at these sell sheets right now, you are missing out because they're awesome, including an actual picture of Carlos Correa holding up his Super Fractor Auto, holding that up for all to see. So baseball at the National, it's there.
Thank goodness, yeah. I mean, it seems like it would be wrong to not have a baseball product release at the National. Thank you, Topps, for coming through. But that's not Topps' only product. They've actually got another one, blending sports and entertainment. 2016 Topps WWE Heritage, always a big hit at the National, delivering 4 rock tribute cards and 2 hits in every box. From the following list are your hits. Look for autographs and 2 brand new pieces of content, Diva Kiss cards and autographed Diva Kiss cards. Yes, they've been in the flagship WWE product, first time in Heritage. Also look for Swatch relics, Survivor Series Matt relics, and NXT Matt relics, which are also new. Other hits might include commemorative patch cards, printing plates. In addition to those 2 hits, you're going to find 3 insert cards in every pack. So your pack hits are going to include a Turn Back the Clock, a Record Breaker, and neither a WCW / NWO All-Star. And then, like I said, your Rock Tribute cards. Never mind that little bit of an error there. I should have put that under box breaks. But anyway, one of the things that I'm most excited about, though, is I love the traditional card stock of Heritage. It's one of the reasons that people, you know, like the brand. It's transitioned over very well to wrestling, and the fact that you're going to have the Diva Kiss cards and Diva autograph Kiss cards on that clay stock, I think, is really cool. Occasionally you get a little bit of smearing with the lipstick. The girls are usually pretty good on those glossier finish cards, but that's going to be cool on the matte finish. So people will be enjoying that for sure. It's got a 110 card base set featuring today's top superstars, divas, rookies, and NXT talent, as well as WWE legends. And this is going to be featured on the classic 1986 Topps baseball design. So
I like it. That is a classic design. And Rob, this next product is a little specialized. I'm going to need you to take care of it, because I'm not understanding entirely, but I know there's something awesome hidden in what this is.
I'll be glad to handle this, because in addition to being a collector, one of my other hobbies actually is I'm a bit of a mafiologist. Growing up in Chicago, I was pretty much fascinated with the outfit, and learned all I could about there, expanded to the East Coast, learned even about Detroit and Cleveland. But Leave It to Historic Autographs, which comes out with some really great niche products, to dedicate an entire set to the mob. And they've got 2 versions of this product launching at the National. One is their set box, where you get a complete 40-card low-numbered base set, and then in addition, 10 of 20 high-number cards and 3 to 4 inserts in every set box. In addition, 1 autographed redemption card in every case. Every case has 60 set boxes, so you have a 1 in 60 chance of getting an autographed redemption card. There's going to be sequentially numbered gold foil cards in here. There's going to be discounts and free coupons for Beckett grading services as a bonus. Limited edition specialty promo cards, only available at the 2016 National. Redemption cards and for the autographs include mobsters, lawmen, and the actors that played them. Some of the names on the list are one of the head of the original five families, Joe Bonanno, J. Edgar Hoover, original director of the FBI, John Gotti, Marlon Brando, Elliot Ness, a.k.a. Untouchables.
Wait, J. Edgar Hoover was a mob boss?
No, he was a lawman. Al Pacino, no. Mickey Cohen, boss of the L.A. Rackets, Carlo Gambino, one of the most ruthless gangsters ever, Jimmy Hoffa, Robert De Niro, Sean Connery, Henry Hill, and many more.
But do they have a James Cagney?
Don't know. I don't know. I hope so. He played a good gangster.
Oh, yeah. He played the best gangster multiple times.
Yeah, he did.
But
yeah, he did.
That is... So either way, lots of mob fun at the National.
Yeah, and that's just the set box. Now, for higher-end collectors, they've got a truly premium product that incorporates its own PSA set registry, which has become status quo and the norm for historic autograph products. The premium box is going to deliver two BGS graded the mob trading cards and one to two signatures in every premium box. So no one per case, you're getting one to two in every box. I mentioned, it has its own set registry, and every collector completing the 60 card Beckett graded set will receive a $2,000 cash reward from Historic Autographs to help offset the cost. And there's a case hit in here, but it's not the traditional case hit. There's a Historic Autographs the Mob t-shirt in every case. Additional names on the autograph checklist include guys like Thomas Dewey, Joe Spinell, and Melvin Purvis, Chaz Palminteri, and a bunch. Roy DeMeo, absolutely ruthless killer. Ruthless. Look him up and read his MO. And he basically took over the Murder, Inc. crew. Man, nasty, nasty guy. So I don't glorify, what these guys do. It's just part of history. So if that's of interest to you, there's going to be two different versions of this product for you to chase. And that's going to wrap up a loaded Hot in the Shop for the week of August 1st, National Week.